year. It's based upon forecasts from winter depth to the end of the year of known pressures, change, etc. And that's 3.4 million, which about 1.1 million, like 1.1% of the net, which our net, which is £275 million. At that stage, it's about 3 million pounds. The original forecast. In the year, we've got £36 million worth of savings to deliver, which was a challenging target. And most of the sort of the argument was caused by concerns of some of those reacting mitigation actions in place to try and treat the police situation and updating us as the year progresses as in the report. So going through the report, you mentioned there the 3.4 million for measures. You see on page 44, there's a nice clear sort of the major areas of areas. So the major source of concern there is the social services. They're projecting just under 3 million, 2.995, additional £3 million, which came from emergency. That's a major source. Again, mainly due to savings have been delivered. There's also an element of caseloads and pressures as well. I think it's around about 2.3 million in terms of savings and about probably £70,000 in terms of case pressures, children, etc. Again, there's also the mitigation in place to try to bring that down. The judges are also services and stuff, so the magic actions to bring that down. There's a series of data updates as to where things are. That's a couple of things to note out. Since setting the budget, the council's been hit with the charge for carbon reduction allowances and street lighting. When the budget was set, that was something we weren't aware of. During the year, and that's around about £100,000 in asset management. So that's going to be a push on the budget. That's the downside. On the good side, we've had some additional repayment bonus in this community worth £232,000. That essentially can mitigate the street action costs. Okay. Mentioned there again, funds and wellbeing, so it's 2.35 million in terms of actions on savings, that's on page 46, and the rest on terms of care packages, etc. A very small variance on leisure. Regeneration environments is on target. Transmission of resources, very small variance. We mentioned there in terms of corporate budgets, it's a new challenge target about the council to be aware, and also corporate commission procurement. Because the large amount, between the two of them, they're worth around £12 million. So obviously that's a high degree sort of checking and visibility for us. Perhaps we should go to table 4. Table 4 has an analysis that there's 140 sales options between the year and kind of people between red and green and blue to alert, etc. And that gives you sort of the analysis. We've got around about £11 million of savings, we can see the high risk, and another £8 million of concerns. Now, that does not mean that those are not delivered, it's just that this concerns. You'll see the example of the £11 million at high risk, £368,000 would be delivered already in 2 months. So it's not because that £11 million won't be delivered, but there's risk of a grand value to it. Okay. So in this case, I know that some mitigation areas are possibly to call. There's a section regarding income and debt, just to walk through that. That just gives you an update as to where we are, and perhaps an interesting fact is that you can carry back at 6.5, which is mentioned that the level of debt at the end of the year was £2 million. The year before that, £26 million, and £4 million kind of improvement on debt. Yeah, it shows you the positive action taking place in terms of the going over the page, it's where there's just a forecast period of top GM4 balances. If the £3.1 million, what's the outcome of the year? And sort of taking into account the impact on the million goals, we've ended up 14.4 million in our GM4 balances, and our focus at the moment is that we're expecting around 15 million to stop the coming year. The GM4 balances are sort of forecast what's required to cope with some of these things, including loss grants, issues regarding income. We have amazing things like flooding, etc. What's the series of forecast, giving some reflecting on these versions, etc. Just that time to go through really. That's probably kind of summary of the open position. What are any questions?
Just on the carbon reduction increase, how come the council wasn't aware that this charge was coming?
My understanding was that was announced after the budget was set. So it wasn't to do with, I think, legislation and changes was after the budget was set. That's my understanding.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Chair. Comment rather than question. I mean, it's pleasing on the debt is 6.5, there's a 4 million pound reduction, but the council of this size, 22 million, is still on the maximum certificate to be for us to be in. You know, I take it that's going to be a follow up again.
Yes, we do have a challenge. In last year, so we changed our procedures. We have shorter time spans in terms of issuing management systems. So we can do these bailiffs where possible. We're not checking to see what we need to do that. And obviously, I'm working on principles where we try to adopt those, we try to be where possible. In fact, think in advance where possible, so we try to raise those in the first place. What's the other thing?
Anybody else have a question?
Excuse me, I can't hear you. Please, can you put the mic on, please? Thank you.
Of the debtors, of the 22, how much is historical debt? Do you keep carrying over?
Debt stay live until they are written off, so there will be some historical debt. There is no penalty. I'm just checking the appendices that's back in the doors. Probably need to get back to you in terms of sort of analysis. I can see where that £50 million down over the years if that's what you see. But the, I suppose that on page 49, which I'll go on to the early point, there's an analysis there in terms of where the actual debts are over. Or to, so you see for there, for example, 11.8 million for 59. 11.8 million pounds comes to third reminder, which means that another 11 million pounds isn't to third reminder. So 11 million pounds is fairly sort of new debt. That's 11 million pounds is old debt. That's the question.
Anyone else?
Yes.
Just a simple question. I was interested to see the suggested growth reductions, which are the words in February, but we've got another look at it. And I'm not sure whether is that effectively a one-off or whether it's
spend as of May was very low, 1.3 million, which only about 2% spent, just extremely low. My performance cut is down to 12%. And we're taking a bit of a spike to reduce some of these and quite a lot of work to do my schools, etc. So, it's quite low in terms of spend. There's a whole series of other things that we've been what kind of schemes, which is sort of listed in the appendices, but going through for the list of kind of absolute some of the things that are taking place. Things include like universal free school meals, which is being sent to kitchens in schools, a lot of work around schools and buildings. In terms of generation, we've got the regional growth fund, which was probably increased during the year as I mentioned in May. And again, in transmission resources, we've got a refresh program as well, in terms of IT kits being rolled out around the council. There's a list of variations in the table too, what things like changing, as reflects, say, new grants coming in, schemes being moved into storage and the like. Later tables really are around costs, the cost of capital program. The capital program is seen from numerous sources, including borrowing, grants, and revenue, etc. And basically, the bigger program is money to borrow at the moment. So, that funded it's about 9% cost to us, £1 million. So, for each £1 million capital program to borrow, so it's around about £90,000 a year. Exactly. So, again, we're keen to make sure we control our program, maximise our grant opportunities as well. That's probably the major. It's it. We have at the moment to spend quite a lot.
Who pays the GPs carrying out these examinations?
Health
check, yeah.
NHS.
It is NHS, is it? NHS were going to come to the aid of the party on several things where we have a responsibility and we just want to know this as well.
We'll get the Chancellor again to the younger.
I'm most grateful to you, Chair.
Okay, thanks very much. Are we happy to note this? Yes. Thanks again, Peter. And now we'll move on to the last item on the agenda, which is the work programme. Mike, are you going to come to do this or not? Well, it's in my head.
Thanks, Chair. So this is a brief update, just related to 2.3, which is really what happened at the last meeting, which was the agreement for the Chair, Vice Chair, spokespersons to meet prior to this meeting, which we did in July, just to review what was outstanding from last year in terms of the coordinating committee and the work programme. I'm really happy to take some fresh eyes onto what might be considered going for the work programme this evening. So feedback from that meeting, the clear agreement was that future council would obviously be the priority. Obviously, that was first on the agenda tonight, so we've got all the form in terms of scrutinising the future options. So that's going to be prioritised across all the committees during the next, during September, October. Paragraph 3.3, again, have that discussion as well in relation to constituency committees, and so we've got that recommendation that following the future council scrutiny, that constituency committees will be. So whether we want to actually look for nominations for that, even though
we'll do that
close to the time, okay, so perhaps if
they have
the there was also a discussion about community impact policy and reports have been taken to regeneration of the environment. I think in January, that was sort of the top performed. I'd actually like to sort of speak more about that as a potential item to call across the
table. Paul Hayes put down the mental board, and it was because of concerns that policies on licensing, policies on fast food outlets, policies on planning policies, doesn't necessarily always come together and help address that issue and really help them make that kind of policy together. And
Paragraph 3.5 just refers to some of the other potential items that were discussed and made. It was agreed really the best way to perhaps review those was the chair, vice chair, boss, supposed to just have a meeting prior to the next formal meeting. Just kind of review that council, that's the review the content of the wider group of work program, looking at what the other policy and performance committees are looking at. Also, quality assurance of previous reviews and looking at any practice, I think that's kind of stepped out to be replicated and reviewing the consistency of that recommendation. And then finally, in terms of section 4, if you learn anything that was discussed to us, what we haven't got on the as an appendix to this report is the proposed work programmes for the committees, because they'll be meeting over the next couple of weeks. And so I think we did discuss this at the last meeting, which was about whether a coordinating committee really should be scheduled after to come back to the committee cycle. And so the proposal is on the recommendation on
that. Just whether we were as a committee on it with the driver who we were passing for the committee, so a reflector of what we've done. And I think the consensus around the table last committee was that we were probably more effective as reflecting on what they've done. And so for that reason, we're at one of the recommendations of this report is that we shift the cycle, that we shift our meetings to the end of the cycle rather than the beginning of the cycle. That's one of the recommendations.
So that's really the brings us to the recommendations, and obviously that would involve kind of committee services looking at the schedule for the last two committee cycles in, I think that's January, February.